On March 25, 2016, Enex Jean-Charles became the new interim prime minister of Haiti. His government's mission to complete the electoral process and establish the political stability. To give us an update on Haiti's latest political events, we invited Peter Elder Bernard, attorney and political analyst. Peter, welcome to the program again.
Thank you very much for having me once more. It's been a while. It's been a while indeed, too long.
Yes, actually, you have been traveling many times in Haiti so far, so been very active in the country and also here in the United States. So now we have a new government. After a long process and struggle, as always. So what next?
Well, we do have a new government, but I think that we may in fact be in the middle of another crisis. I see a crisis growing because of the simple fact that we have not yet resolved the problems which plagued the previous elections in which impeded the completion of the electoral process. And this government thus far elected the way, I mean, placed in power the way it was, still has not fulfilled the desire and the requirements that some imposed by much of the political class in Haiti. So I think that until we are able to resolve these issues, I think we are heading straight towards another crisis, and probably a bigger one this time.
Based on the February 6 agreement between Jocelyn Privert and Michel Martelly, the interim government should last 120 days, which is even in the counting we realize that.
Even that was inconsistent.
Yes, well, that was inconsistent. So we think that they know their math, right?
Hopefully.
But at the beginning, it was already there was an inconsistency. Now. But what would be, we can say, the status of this agreement?
Well, I always say we have to put things in their proper context. People have made much about the agreement because they say you can't go outside of the agreement. The agreement is almost sacred. I say no. I say that the agreement is it's an agreement between two entities, which still exist. It's an agreement between the executive branch and the legislative branch. And they had these two branches represented by their principal agents. The agreement is just like a contract. It is not a convention. It is not a treaty. So it can be modified at any time. In law, we speak of what we call a meeting of the minds. If you have a meeting of the mind, then you have the process of contract formation. Here in this agreement, there was a meeting of the mind as to what they wanted. But because the current context requires otherwise, they may revisit this agreement, even though the signatories of the previous agreement, I mean, of the current agreement are no longer there. Technically, the agents are not there, but the entities are still there. So if there is a meeting of the mind between the current executive branch and the legislative branch as to necessary changes to that agreement, that is absolutely possible. And that is where I think they should go.
And some have concern regarding how long this interim situation will last, because we know with Haiti, time is not very important. And we know that this instability and with no democratic elected government, established government, it also doesn't help the country neither. Mm-hmm. Everything is on hold right now.
Yes, everything is on hold to a certain extent. The government is functioning, however, to the extent possible. But we cannot engage the country in definite projects because this is, in fact, like you said, an interim government. So its mission is very limited and very short, should be very short. Listen, my position as to the transition itself has always been different from what I hear outside. My position is that we need a real transition in Haiti. We need a transition, the transition of the reset. We need to hit that reset button with a transition and go back probably 30 years and do over what we did and what we did wrong. We've learned quite a bit over the course of the past 30 years. So it is probably time for us to re-examine ourselves, to come with a new social contract, not just the Constitution, but a new social contract, a new understanding between the different components of the problem, and arrive at an understanding to a project of governance for the next 25 years. The diaspora must be included. It is essential. We need to inject new blood in the veins of this republic. So as Congresswoman was saying before, you know, the necessity of having new blood, the emergence of new blood, new leadership is imperative for Haiti right now.
And now going back to the current elections, which is not going to be held in April 24th, as it was supposed to, in less than 1 minute, please answer this. Many political parties and local observers, they claim fraud to the last election, and then they request for a vote verification. Is that possible?
Commission is absolutely an imperative of the moment. We must arrive at a commission, because the legitimacy of the election will be in question. The parliament legitimacy will be in question. The presidential election legitimacy will be in question. So we must arrive at a certain sense of transparency, and that is essential to go forward.
Thank you very much, Peter. And I'm looking forward to have you again on the program too for more updates.
Right? Thank